Shabbat Shalom. This week's Torah portion is called Parshas Vayeira. It happens immediately after the circumcision of Abraham. And it talks about him receiving the three angels who are going to announce to him the upcoming birth of his son Isaac. But the Parsha ends with perhaps one of the most dramatic scenes in the Torah about the binding of Isaac, where God commands Abraham, it's the last trial, God commands Abraham to sacrifice his son on Har Moriah, Mount Moriah, where afterwards the temple will be built. The verse says, Vayashkem Avram Baboker, V'yachavoshes Chamaro, V'yakachashneinu Moshe, that Abraham got up in early in the morning, he didn't procrastinate, and he saddled his donkey, and he took his two youths with him. The two youths were his son Yishmael and his servant Eliezer. All of the commentaries say that perhaps this was Abraham's greatest quality. Even though he was a man of kindness, God told him to take his son and offer him as an offering. He didn't procrastinate. He got up early in the morning. And this is perhaps the lesson for each of us. When God tells you to do something, there's a mitzvah, don't put it off, do it right away. But Rabbi Michal of Zlotzitz comes from a completely different place. Okay? He says there's a teaching, and a very subtle teaching for each person. He says, when it says, Vayashkem Avram Baboker, that Abraham got up early in the morning, it's a message to each person, you know what? Wake up. Wake up. Realize that you're not using all of the qualities that God gave you in the best way, or that we're not yet where we want to be. What do we have to do? He says, Vayachavosh Chamaro. It means that he saddled his donkey, but it could also mean that he took control of his materiality. He refocused himself into his spiritual life, not his physical life. When a person refocuses away from physical into spiritual, where God is the most important, but my needs are less important, what does he do? Vayakach et shnei neravito. Again, the simple translation is he took his two youths with him. It could also be translated shnei neurav. The years of his youth. A person transforms, he elevates, he repairs all of the lack of focus that he had before in his earlier life, and he's focusing, he takes the whole thing by acting now, transforming even his past into something positive. Okay, that's the message for each person, okay? There is, the past is not lost. We can transform the past into something positive. When we realize that we didn't use our strength to the best in the past, and we refocus ourselves now, that's, we're taking even the past and transforming it into something positive. Shabbat Shalom.